Okay, you want to talk about the tefillin. So it says in Halacha Mem Gimel, we talk about, you see the shin, the tefillin of the head. You see that it's three cuts. It's really separate. It's separate from the beginning till the end. Mamash cut till the end. And then what we do is we put it together, we squish it together, so it becomes the head. So really the cut has to be two mekomatefer, two where it really gets sewed up. That's the outside. Now the next thing is, the shins, you know, the yud of the shins, you see over here, I have four. So the inside is called the yud, outside is the vav of the zayin. So since, what's the problem? Because some people say it has to be a shin inside. It's called yav choyk toichev and choyk yirich. Means that this one, it's sticking out. So we have a shin, so it's okay. And also we said the last one has to be till the end. But this one has to have a shin complete. But if you see it, since it's attached till the end, it doesn't look like a shin. Since it doesn't look like a shin, so in Mel it's very hard to know that it's a shin. So it says, Mishnah Berurah says, yesh ma'gdolim, they used to cut away in the end, so it should look like a shin inside. Because it has like four, has to be a shin inside the letters, like sticking it in. So this is the cut, but he says, most of them, the godin, that's the custom today. We don't leave it cut, we leave it complete. But that's the inside, those, the yudin, that has to make sure that it touched till the end. And that's what the Ramon Pastin. It has to be till the end. Okay, the next halacha, we're going to talk about the titura and the ma'bal. Before we talk about the parshas inside, there has to be extra cloth, has to be a gid surrounded, the titura. Now you have over here titura, means after you put over here inside, you put inside the cloth, you know, the parshas, the scrolls, has to be closed. This is below down, that's the covering. That's called what? Titur. So that's basically in order to cover the piabat. Okay, today they do part of one part, but there's some children do it separately. But it's also should be one part of connecting the clothes, the bottom. Now in the side, now this is Halacha L'Moshe Misina, you have that. Now in the side, now if you see, it's called Ma'abalta. This is like a path. You see where they move the scroll, the straps. So it has to be a Ma'abalta, it has to be something to pass with. But in order to know the difference between the bottom part, to make sure that it's the bottom part, that's why I don't know if you saw cutting. You see in the side is a cutting between the head and the hand. Why? So what we know for sure is that my balto is called, in order to know that what, that is the titu over here. So in order to know it's coming in the bottom, that's why we cut the side. So when we look at it, we understand, oh, is something covering in the below in order to cover the partial. So the my balto and the titu is halacha, the Moshe Misin, that we have to do that. And it has to be the word that one side is more longer than the other side. That's how, if you look, you make it like this, like, and see over here, so, like a certain cut, to show you the trilling itself has to be round and that. But, you know, over here, like where it's connected, that's a little bit smaller. In order to show that you should know, this is the titura, we have a titura, and the ma'abalta is the path for the tefillin in order to remove the straps, and both of them, halacha, the Moshe, misin. We will stop over here tomorrow, we'll learn about the scroll itself, how we have to tie it up, and have to be which kind of gid, or eger, if that eger has to be poro, show. Clean good. We'll talk about it tomorrow. Have an easy fast today.